From a young age, I've always loved science. I was interested in pursuing a career in research. When I got into MUSC for graduate school, I started my PhD and I didn't really know what I wanted to study. I met Dr. Norris.
So she asked me what I did, and I said I work on heart valve disease. And she revealed that she had Ehlers-Danlos syndrome.
I was diagnosed with HEDS when I was around 19 years old, but there's no direct treatment and really not a lot of research going on into why this is happening or what we can do about it. Most days I have been able to manage it, but I'd be lying if I didn't say I'm in pain basically every second of every day.
I asked her what the gene was, and she said, nobody knows.
He was like, well, do you want to try and find the gene? Find the gene, we can do that. We started with a large family that had HEDS to kind of narrow down and find a genetic cause. From that, we were able to have a small list of genes that we then narrowed down to one causative gene for HEDS. With the genetic registry that we developed, we found this mutation in other patients and other families as well. This was the first gene discovery for HEDS.
MUSC really enabled us to become a world-leading institution with a focus on Ehlers-Danlos syndrome.
Even as a student, I always had a seat at the table. To have leadership and administration listen to someone who was, you know, just a PhD student is really rare and unique. It takes a long time to make a scientific discovery. This process is slow, so to have such a big discovery so early in my scientific career is kind of unheard of. It made me really excited for every next step along the way.